Hello students and warm welcome to all for today's lecture on solar energy part 4. In today's lecture we'll be covering some solar energy collection devices in detail. A solar collector is a device that collects and concentrates the solar radiation from the sun. These devices are primarily used for active solar heating and allow for the heating of water for personal use. These collectors are generally mounted on roof and must be very sturdy as they are exposed to variety of atmospheric condition. The use of this solar collector provides an alternative for traditional domestic water heating using a water heater, potentially reducing the energy cost over the time. As well as in domestic setting, a large number of these collectors can be combined together in an array and used to generate the electricity in solar thermal power plant. There are many different types of solar collector available in the market, but all of them are constructed with the same basic premises in mind. In general, there is some material that is used to collect and focus the energy of sun and use to heat the water or air. The simplest of these devices uses the black material surrounding pipe that through which the water flows. The black material absorbs the solar radiation very well, and as the material heats up, the water in the surrounding also heated and the temperature of water will start increasing. This is very simple design, but in actual the collectors are very complex in nature. The absorber plate can be used if a high temperature increase isn't necessary, but generally the devices that uses the reflective material to focus the sunlight and result in higher temperature. There are basically two types of solar collector available, that is flat plate collector and evacuated tube solar collector. Of course, there are many more types than that, but here we are going to cover these two types and few more types in the upcoming slides. These collectors are simply metal boxes that have some sort of transparent glazing as a cover on the top of dark color absorber plate. The sides and bottom of the collector are usually covered with insulation to minimize the heat loss to the other parts of collector. Solar radiation passes through the transparent glazing material and hits the absorber plate. This plate heats up, thus by transferring the heat to either water or air that is held between the glazing and the absorber plate. Sometimes this absorber plate are painted with this special coating designed to absorb and retain the heat better than the traditional black paint. These plates are usually made up of metal that is good conductor of heat, usually the copper or aluminium. Following are the components of the solar collector. Number 1, absorber plate. 2, enclosure. 3, flow passage. 4, cover plate, and 5, insulation. So in upcoming slide we will see those components in detail. The first component we are going to see is the absorber plate. Absorber plate is usually made up of copper, steel or plastic. The surface is covered with the flat black material of high absorptance. If the copper or steel is used, it is possible to apply the selective coating that will maximize the absorptance of solar energy and minimizes the radiation emitted by the plate. The next component we are going to see is the cover plate. To reduce the convective and radiative heat loss from the absorber plate, one or two transparent covers are generally placed above the absorber plate. Next is the insulation. These are some materials such as fiberglass, and they are placed at the back and sides of the collector to reduce the heat loss. Enclosure. Enclosure is the box that the collector is enclosed in, hold to other component like pipes and all, which will protect from the weather. Next is the flow passage. Flow passage conducts the working fluid through the collector. If the working fluid is liquid, the flow passage is usually a tube that is attached to the absorber plate. If the working fluid is air, the flow passage should be below the absorber plate to minimize the heat loss. This type of solar collector uses a series of evacuated tubes to heat the water for use. These tubes utilize the vacuum or evacuated space to capture the sun ray while minimizing the heat loss of heat to the surrounding. They have an inner metal tube which acts as an absorber plate which is connected to a heat pipe to carry the heat collected from the sun to water. These heat pipes is initially a pipe where the fluid contents are under very particular pressure. At this pressure, the hot end of the pipe has boiling liquid in it while the cold end of pipe has a condensing vapor. This allows for thermal energy to move more efficiently from one end to other end of pipe. Once the heat from the sun moves from hot end to the cold end, the thermal energy is transported into the water which is used for further purpose. Next, we are going to see the collector performance. How we are going to calculate the performance of the collector when it is exposed to the atmosphere? The thermal performance of the collector can be calculated from the first law energy balance. According to the first law of thermodynamics, for a simple flat plate collector, an instantaneously steady state equation can be drawn, which can be written as below. The useful energy gain can be denoted by capital Q suffix U, which is nothing but equal to the energy absorbed by the collector minus heat loss to the surrounding. By this way, we can calculate the useful energy gain of the collector from the sun's radiation. Next, we are going to see the detailed terminologies of the equation. First, we'll see the absorbed energy. Absorbed energy is equal to AC into FR into S, where the lost energy is equal to AC into FR into UL into TI minus TA. Now we will see what do you mean by each and every term. AC is the collector area in meter square. FR is the heat removal factor, which is the unit less quantity. S is the absorbed solar radiation, which is measured in joule per meter square. UL is the heat transfer loss coefficient, which is measured in joule per meter square degree centigrade. TI is the mean absorber plate temperature measured in degree C. TA is the ambient temperature measured in degree C. So useful energy gain can be denoted as or can be written as absorbed energy minus lost energy, as we have seen in the previous slide. This collector, sometimes also known as a parabolic trough, that uses the highly reflective material to collect and concentrate the heat energy from the solar radiation. These collectors are composed of parabolically shaped reflective section connected into a long trough, a pipe that carries water in the place at center of the trough, so the sunlight collected by the reflective material is focused on the pipe, heating the content. These are very high powered collectors and are thus generally used to generate the steam from the solar thermal power plant and are not used in the residential application. This trough can be extremely effective in generating the heat from the sun, particularly those that can pivot the tracking sun in the sky, ensure the maximum sunlight collection. These collectors are large parabolic dish composed of some reflective material that focuses the sun energy on a single point. The heat from these collectors is generally used for driving the Stirling engine. Although very effective at collecting the sunlight, they must be actively tracking the sun across the sky over a period of time. These dishes can work alone or combined into an array to gather even more energy from the sun. Point focus collector and similar apparatus can also be utilized to concentrate the solar energy for use with the concentrated photovoltaics. In this case, instead of producing heat, the sun energy is converted directly into the electricity. With high efficiency photovoltaic cell, designed specifically to harness the concentrated solar energy. Parabolic dish collector is a concentrating solar collector that is similar in appearance to the large satellite dish, but it has mirror-like reflector surface and an absorber at a focal point. A parabolic dish system uses a computer and a dual-axis tracking to follow sun across the sky and concentrate the sun ray onto a receiver that is located at the focal point in the front side of dish. In some systems, a heat engine such as the Stirling engine is linked to the receiver to generate the electricity. Parabolic dish system can reach up to 1000 degrees C at the receiver and achieve the highest efficiency for converting the solar energy into the electricity in small power capacity range. Next is the power tower. The solar power tower, also known as a central power plant or heliostat power plant or power tower, is a type of solar furnace using a tower to receive the focused sunlight. It uses an array of flat movable mirror called heliostat to focus the sun ray upon a collector tower that is the target. The concentrated solar thermal is seen one visible solution for renewable and pollution-free energy. Early design of the solar power tower uses the focus ray to heat the water and use the resulting steam to power the turbine. Newer design uses the liquid sodium that have been demonstrated, and systems uses the molten salt that is 40% potassium nitrate and 60% sodium nitrate as the working fluid are now in operation. These working fluid have high heat capacity, which can be used to store the energy before using it to boil the water to drive the turbine. This design also allow power to generate when the sun is not shining in the sky. So now we have come to the end of today's lecture. I hope all the solar collection devices that have been discussed today in lecture are very much clear to you. If there is any doubt about today's lecture, kindly drop a comment in the comment box and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to receive the more update. Wish you happy learning. Stay home, stay